For example, like another example of how we can simplify. We were told in the university and the schools that just remember this formula: f of t u of t minus a. The Laplace transform will be the Laplace transform of f of t plus a times e raised to the power minus as, or something like that. Okay, as whatever. So let me, if I take this function, suppose f of t, okay, something like this. Now f t u of t minus 2, this means this much, this is f of t u of t minus 2. Can't I write this as f of t minus 2 plus 2, or plus 2 minus 2? Okay, u of t minus 2. In some sense, if I take this minus 2 common, because now they are both in shifting, can't I write this equation, this whole equation as f of t plus 2 right shifted by 2, if I take this minus 2 common in both the sides. So f of t plus 2, this was one technique which was induced by me, f of t plus 2 right shifted by 2. So right shifted by 2 means e raised to power minus 2t. F of t plus 2 is the Laplace transform. I have to take f of t plus 2, the Laplace transform multiplied by e raised to power minus 2s. Simple as that. You can write, you can actually simplify. What we will say, I am telling you, what the proposal. They will say that in some sense we can think, we can left shift this function, then multiply by ut. So if I left shift this function, then it will come here. Now take the Laplace transform, then again right shift, and then you, therefore you will get. They will give a big explanation of approximately at least 15 minutes. And just simply you can think of it. So just try to simplify. I'm telling you, if you know the trick of how to represent anything, the secret again, this is again secret number 2. If you know to represent any function in form of convolution with delta of t minus 2 or something like that, you have simplified a lot of things. So the secret is just try to represent the function in form of convolution or the right shift left shift. This I can also write as right shifted by 2. So if you know how to represent this, then everything is simplified, because this delta of t minus 2 will be direct multiplication, and you are just remained with solving this part, this half part. Let me give you an example. For example, if I give you that r of this ramp of t minus 2 convolved with some, what we tell, u of t minus 2. Now just see, this is shifted by 2, this is again shifted by 2. Shifting by 2, shifting by 2. Can't I write it as ramp of t convolved with delta of t minus 2 convolved with u of t convolved with delta of t minus 2. This 2 right shifting, they will get as right shifting by 4. Delta of t minus 4 times this ramp t convolved with u t. This will become parabola of t convolved with. So this will be the answer, simple as that. And the parabola of t is nothing but this is nothing but t square. And for t square, the z transform is nothing but, for t it is, what is, for 1 it is 1 by s, for t it is 1 by s square. So for t it is 2 by s cube. So 2 by s cube is the answer, simple as that. Okay, so you can just simplify the things. For example, if I am giving you sine omega t u of t minus 2, the answer will be simple. Just you have to take, this will be sine of omega t minus 2 plus 2, you will have to do, or plus 2 minus 2. So just take the minus is common. When I take the minus is common, it simply means that I am convolving it with delta of t minus 2. And whenever you have simplified this process as convolution, then it will be directly multiplication in the frequency domain. So this will correspond to e raised power minus 2t, and this will correspond to some form of whatever it will be in convolution. So just understand that these are the small techniques, that convolution to multiplication. Out of this basic, what we tell, this multiplication or convolution theorem, out of just this theorem, we can simplify a heck lot. So you just need to exploit all these things. Never go by what professor say. Just try to think and try to, when you go home, just always try to simplify how you can do this stuff simply. Because the more simply you understand, the better you will be able to, even initially, it may look very difficult. But when you go at very basic level of it and try to understand and deal with it, you will be amazed at how much you can simplify. This looks very like awkward initially, okay. But when you go in very difficult questions, this will be the best reliable technique. This will be always reliable. Because the amount of calculations you will be, this will always be reliable, okay. Just keep it in mind. You will understand this when exams come.